Their job was sacred, guarding our nation's nuclear missiles. Their crime? Buying, supplying, and even dropping acid, sometimes here in Denver. Good evening, I'm Ann Trujillo.
And I'm Shannon Ogden. And tonight we are learning new details about this drug-fueled ring involving more than a dozen airmen at F.E. Warren Air Force Base in Cheyenne. Denver 7's Jackie Cray is here with just how widespread this was.
Yeah, well, this went undetected for months. These are security forces airmen. They work above ground guarding missile sites. They're always supposed to be prepared, even when they're off duty. A slip up on social media in 2016, an airman posted a video on Snapchat, and that blew this investigation wide open. Court documents describe airmen partying using LSD, cocaine, and other drugs. None of the airmen was accused of doing so while on duty.
Well, number one, you're not supposed to use drugs, period. Anything to do with the nuclear business. This is not a new problem.
Retired Air Force Colonel Charlie Simpson says this kind of thing has happened many times before in his 30 years of service. Young security policemen can have a hard time adjusting and make poor decisions. The ringleader, Airman First Class Nicholas Harris, pleaded guilty and admitted to buying, using, and distributing LSD at least a handful of times to fellow airmen at parties in Denver and other places from spring 2015 to early 2016. On one occasion, a group of them used LSD, watched YouTube videos, and then got on their skateboards traveling around Denver. Harris would also make posters with instructions for first-time LSD users and drink Sunny D, knowing the vitamin C would intensify their LSD trips. The AP quotes Harris during a court-martial hearing saying, quote, "I absolutely just loved altering my mind," end quote. Harris was sentenced to 12 months in jail and other penalties. Jackie Crea, Denver 7.